गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एयर पोल्यूशन. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज वाटर पोल्यूशन. स्टूडेंट, यू नो दैट वाटर इज द सेकेंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट लाइफ सपोर्टिंग सब्सटेंस. वी नीड वाटर फॉर ड्रिंकिंग, बाथिंग, कुकिंग फूड एंड वॉशिंग आवर क्लोथ्स एंड यूटेंसिल्स. एग्रीकल्चर रिक्वायर्स अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर फॉर ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स. बट आवर डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज add some materials to the water which is spoil its quality and change its smell and color, and this water is known as polluted water. So the water pollution may be defined as the adverse change in the composition or condition of water, and when water is polluted it becomes less suitable for use. So the substance that pollute water, they are known as water pollutant. So if we talk about the sources of water pollution, we can say that the discharge of untreated domestic sewage into river leads to water pollution. Excessive use of fertilizers and pesticides in agriculture also cause water pollution. Discharge of toxic waste from the factories and refineries that pollute water. Oil spills that are accidentally released to oil by tankers in ocean, they also may cause marine water pollution. And the improper disposal of litter, we can say garbage such as plastic bag, wrappers, bottles, that also lead water pollution. If we talk about the case study of Ganga, we know that the Ganga is the one of the most famous river in India, and millions of people depend on it for their daily needs. Student, the recent study of WWF means Worldwide Fund for Nature found that Ganga is one of the 10 most endangered rivers in the world, and the pollution level has been rising for many years. We have reached this stage because the towns and the cities through which the river flow throw large quantities of garbage, untreated sewage, dead bodies and many other harmful things directly into the river. So in fact the river is dead at many places where the pollution level are so high and the aquatic life cannot survive there. So for to save the Ganga, an ambition plan is launched that is known as Ganga Action Plan, and it was launched in the 1985, and the government in India has launched a new initiative plan to save Ganga, that is National Mission for Clean Ganga, that is known as MSCG, that is launched in 2016. Student, if we talk about the effect of water pollution, we can say that water pollution affects both animals and plants and lead to adverse impact on the aquatic ecosystem, because the sewage gives the maximum opportunity to the pathogens and non-pathogenic microorganisms to grow. So what is pathogenic? Pathogenic means they are disease causing microorganisms that are known as pathogenic. So these pathogenic are responsible for several waterborne disease like diarrhea, typhoid, cholera, dysentery, jaundice and hepatitis. Algae grow in water bodies because of the excessive quantities of chemical which get washed from the film, and these act as a nutrition for the algae to flourish. Once these algae die, they serve as food for the decomposers like the bacteria, and lot of oxygen in the water body gets used up. And by the result, this is decrease in the oxygen level, which may kill all the aquatic organisms. Even the bacteria that present in the water, that feces is also indicator of the to destroy the quality of water. If water has these bacteria, it means that it has been contaminated by fecal matter. And if such water is used by us, it can cause various infection to us. Our next topic is what is potable water and how is water purified. Student, if we want to define the potable water, we can say that the water should look clear without any smell and should not contain microorganisms or air dissolved impurities. So it is essential to purify water before drinking, and water which is suitable for drinking, that is known as potable water. वो water जिसमें कोई भी impurities नहीं होती है, जिसको हम use कर सकते हैं for the drinking, that water is known as potable water. And if we talk about the purification of water, that involve both physical and chemical method. First is filtration. So the suspended impurities present in water can be removed by the filtering water through a fine clothes. And if we boil the water, so filtered water can be made germs free by boiling for 10 to 15 minutes. And if we treat with the chemicals, the filtered water can also be made germ free by adding certain chemicals. That if we talk about the chemical, that is potassium permanganate or chlorine tablets. Treatment of water that involve the use of chlorine tablet or bleaching powder is called chlorination, and we should not use more chlorine tablet because it is also harm for us. So we should reduce, reuse and recycle should be our mantra to reduce the pollution. So student, your chapter is complete. I hope you understood this chapter. So read this chapter.